Good afternoon, folks. I'm Pastor Noel, and I serve at Christ Point Baptist Church here in town. And first of all, to the family, thank you for letting me be a part of this. I hope to be a blessing to you. And then on behalf of the family, those of you who have come to pay your final respects and then to just love on them, thank you for being here too. We've come to this point in time to remember Miss Sandra. I'm sure that she has touched the lives of every person here in some capacity. Her family, certainly, her friends. And for that reason, she's going to be remembered for a long, long time after today. This is not the end of our remembering, is it? We've come to mourn this loss for this immediate family. That's probably going to notice that, you know, the loss is physical, clearly, for every one of you. But for every one of you, and just as recognized by your attendance, we're also going to understand that there is a loss, whether it's just a friend or someone you like to think about. And thing is this, we can mourn, and it's okay. We can grieve, and that's okay, too. You can do this. Here's why you're allowed to mourn, all right? And it's encouraged, because in God's Word, He has told us, blessed are those who mourn. He says, you're blessed, for they shall be comforted. I read one time, and I bet you'll agree with me on this, that the cost of loving someone is grief when we lose them. That's the price. But that just means you love them and you care about them. As a pastor, I want you to know that God, He is not immune to our emotions. He understands what we go through. I very firmly believe this. And as an ever-present God, I believe that He completely understands what we're experiencing, whether that's through life or whether that's through death. But He understands this because of the life and the death and then the eventual resurrection of His Son, Christ Jesus. That's how we know that He understands what we go through. He's experienced all that there is to experience. God's been there too, so to speak. And so He understands. The Old Testament, in the Scripture, it says in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter number 33 and verse number 27, He says, the eternal God is our dwelling place, and underneath are His everlasting arms. And He goes on to say in Psalm 34, I love this, it says, the Lord is near the brokenhearted. He's near. And it says, and He saves those who are crushed in their spirit. And then in Psalm 147, 3, it says, the Lord, 34 said, He's near the brokenhearted, but 147 said, the Lord heals the brokenhearted. It says, and He binds up their wounds. And the psalmist goes on to say, great is our Lord. He's abundant in power. His understanding is beyond all measure. So I encourage you, as you are most likely suffering from brokenheartedness today, many of you, I encourage you, maybe for the first time ever, to lean on the Lord. To lean not, as the Bible says, lean not on your own understanding, but lean on the Lord. I believe that we're not alone this morning, or excuse me, this afternoon, as I'm saying. But I think that God Himself is here with us. And since He is, I think that we can mourn our loss. I also think it's okay to be honest with our feelings and what we're feeling. I'm sure there's been a range. I know Miss Sandra was ill. So I'm sure there's gone feelings from worry to sadness, probably to frustration and aggravation and even anger and to just sorrow and brokenheartedness. I understand. I think it's okay to experience all of those things. It really, really is. But here's one of the good things. We can remember. That's good things we can do. And we can remember Miss Sandra, and we can take time to remember her, but also remember the Lord, and remember to lean in on Him and allow Him to comfort us with her memory. And I think that's a good thing. I am a pastor, and one of the things that I do often is I have to lean on the Lord. And I'd like to do that right now, if you don't mind. Would you join me in praying for just a moment? Then we'll continue on in this service here. Dear Heavenly Father, I, first of all, just rejoice in the fact that I can turn to You, Lord, in my times of need. And so many of us here who know You, Lord, have taken time to turn to You as well through prayer. We don't have to go through any hoops or hurdles. We can lift our voices directly to You in prayer, and I thank You for that, Lord. I thank You for the life of Miss Sandra that we're here to celebrate today, that we're here to celebrate, Lord, to remember. Lord, I thank You so, so very much that for the gift that she was to so many, to her family right here, to family out in the crowd, the friends and the friends of the family, Lord. If nothing else, she brought us all together today, and that's something that we can rejoice in. Father, I pray in Jesus' name, God, that You would be ever present in the lives of those here today, doing just as You promised in the book of Psalms, being near the brokenhearted and comforting to those today. God, I pray that You would present Yourself in such a way that would give what Your word calls the peace that passes all understanding. I know that You can do it, Lord, and I know You will. I pray that You would. And I pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. So, I will have to be the first to admit that I did not know Miss Sandra, but I got to talk to Miss Donna, and I got to find out all kinds of fun things. All kinds of fun things. One of those is that she was a wonderful artist. And sure enough, get here today, and some of that work's on display there in the back. And if you haven't had a chance to go check it out, I encourage you to. Now listen, that's not for sale or for tape. You leave it there. But you go and enjoy looking at what she has put together. My understanding was her husband, Mr. Alvin, he was a carpenter. And he would build different things, and then she would take them and decorate them, make pictures and paintings on them. And still, you can see back there about birdhouses and other things that she's put together. And I'd heard tales, and now I've got to bear witness to tales of just these incredible, like, saw blades and scenic paintings on them. There's one back there that just spoke to my heart. It had a great big buck on it. And so just... it's so, so neat. That's something that's exciting to remember. And then you have something physically still that you can hold that she did. How awesome is that? I thought that that was something that was neat. And just to be able to talk about. I'd still love to see one of these wooden calendars. You told me about these calendars that she would make. I'd love to check one of those out one day. I think that that's wonderful. She loved her grandchildren. As I was reading just through the bulletin, as I'm sure you've done, one of her favorite jobs that she had was being grandma. And I think that you probably know and say, I see you shaking your head. Yeah, buddy, that was one of them. That was one of them. I think I got the most tickled. And of course, you and I were talking, and I didn't want to get tickled with you while we were talking, but afterwards. The most tickled I got was when you and I were talking and you said how much she enjoyed hooking up with her sister, Donna. And the two of them, I understood, like to go and visit thrift stores, is that right? And other establishments, yeah, amongst other places. And you said that they became whole new people when they got together. That they were one person when they were apart and a whole new people when they got together. And I can just imagine the joy that they had being together, that sibling love. I think the other thing that tickled me that you told me about was how she enjoyed a particular song by Bob Seger, that old time rock and roll. Yeah, yeah.
She used to dance from old house.
song that she enjoyed as much as it was the little dance that she liked to do. Well, we're going to have you do a dance off here, boys. You can show us the dance, and we'll do it in her honor. I bet, though, if we had a show of hands, that many of you, especially the grandchildren, her, she really liked to embarrass them trying to do that dance. And I bet if we had a show of hands, you'd say, yeah, I've been embarrassed by it before. Very likely. I got a treat for you. I think we're going to play that. How about it? We just take a moment, and we're just going to marinate in that old time rock and roll for a second. Would you enjoy it? To remember Sandra in your own way, maybe what memories she's left you with, or what stories that you have, or who was this person to you, I suppose. So I want to take just a brief moment and ask if anybody here, this is, like I said, this is a little different, but if there's anyone here who'd like to share a word, like to share a thought about Miss Sandra, I want you to feel free to come either to the podium. Yeah. And just this, as one finishes, you can come up or stand right there where you are. I want to just give you time to remember.
Thank you. It's so great to see so many familiar faces today. And what I'm taking from today is an overwhelming feeling of gratitude for a family that didn't have a lot, but gave a lot. They gave more than they had. They didn't have to be such a pillar for me. They didn't have to be such a rock for me. They didn't have to open their home and let me live with them for 2 years. The kindness that this family has shown to me, and how kind and loving overall the entire family is. They're second to none. You'll never meet a kinder or gentler woman than Sandra Fike. So I hope when we leave here today, what my hope is that we all can show more kindness to each other, more gratitude for what we have. And I hope that we can help each other through this and just help anyone the way that she did, the stranger in need, your own family members, friends. We have a lot to give as human beings, and I think that sometimes we don't give. We're selfish. We think about ourselves, and that word was never synonymous with Sandra. She was the most unselfish, loving, kind human being I have ever met, and that's saying a lot. So when we leave here today, I implore all of you to practice more random acts of kindness. And you see somebody in need, reach out and be kind. Like, you never know. Like, just a touch on the shoulder, a smile, any kind of warm gesture. But I say we do that going forward for Sandra. We try to be better people and kinder and more loving to each other.
Amen for that.
My name is Oslyn, and she was my great-grandma, and I remember when she used to dance around in the kitchen with me, and she used to take out her teeth and say, "Hey, sweetheart," to me, and then we would play goldfish at the table with me, her, and my grandpa, and she used to also sing me lullabies to put me to sleep.
See, I only heard about the dancing around the kitchen. I missed the theme part. That's why we're having this time, like, to really dig in. Are there others? You feel free to share, either where you are or feel free to come forward.
Here's what you'd like to do. Come on, give me a kiss, Dawn.
I guess I'll say something about my Aunt Sandra. Like, I know my Aunt Sandra took care of everybody. And no matter what, every time you go over to her house, she's always in the kitchen. And, like, she's her grandkids. She loves her grandkids. But she loves everybody. And she's just, you know, she was always kind. Always kind. She never, ever, ever had to work to be safe. And she definitely did her job as a caregiver. And she married my grandma's brother. And I think I just think it's beautiful. And I'm just so grateful that they were alive to be there when they needed to be.
Thank you. Are there others? Brother Pat, I think we have another song.
It won't be over.
It's not old time rock and roll.
say something?
Sure.
I didn't know the woman very long. I've been in this family for about 12 years. Obviously, me and Carrie are not married, but I know that every one of those sisters, brothers, they've all been fighters, and I've never met a family that have had such stubborn, stubborn elderlies, you know, that just want to keep fighting and fighting and fighting. They go to the hospital, you know, you think you're going to lose them, and the next thing you know, they're out for months and months, and then they're back in. Grandma Jo was that way, Alvin was that way, Sandra was that way. That woman went through at least 3 surgeries that I can remember, open heart surgery in Omaha. You know, she's kept on fighting and fighting. And she went through surgeries. So, and Alvin, or not Alvin, I'm sorry, Odie, you just, I understand you're the healthiest of all. You just keep on fighting. But one thing I'm going to say is, my gosh, you guys are fighting. You guys got a heck of a fighting family. That's all I'm going to say. So, and I'm proud to be in this family.
Sure, that resonates a lot. Thank you. Friends, just to the remaining, those of us here today, friends and family, it's said that death might end our lives, but it will never end our relationships. And so, let this life, this sweet life of Miss Sandra, let it be a testimony in your lives. Family's going to remain family, and friends are going to remain friends, and death can't stop that. So I just want to encourage you in that today. In fact, God sent His Son. He sent Jesus Christ to ensure that those of us who put our faith and put our trust in Him by asking for forgiveness of sins and looking for His leadership in our lives, He ensures that we're no longer going to see death as an ending, but it's a pit stop on the way to something greater, and that's eternity with Him. But that's only reserved for those who have trusted Him as their Lord and their Savior. I just want to encourage you that if you've not trusted Christ, I want to encourage you to do that. To do that today. Maybe this is the prompting that you need to trust your life to Christ. I also want to encourage you that as those memories of Sandra, as they drop into your thoughts, into your consciousness, that you'll have no choice but to remember. I hope that when you pass a thrift store or a casino that you'll just chuckle. You know, I hope that when you hear that old time rock and roll, you'll do a silly little dance and just remember. That's good. You know, cherish those times. Share those times with each other. Let that legacy continue to live. That's a good thing. Use your name. It's a good thing. I encourage you in that. And when times are tough, and I know that there's going to be this wave of emotions that just come and go, we do something at Christ Point. We offer a service called Grief Share. And it's a program that helps folks who have gone through grief. But one of the things that I've learned through Grief Share is there's something called a grief ambush. It just comes on you sometimes when you're least expecting it. I want to encourage you when those times are toughest, I want to invite you to turn to Christ during those. I know that He understands. We've proven that through His Son. And when He was preparing His disciples, because He knew He was going to leave, when Jesus was preparing His disciples for His departure, He said, I tell you the truth. And I like that. I like being told the truth. He said, and this is the truth. He said, you will weep and mourn while the world rejoices. Now, they're talking about Him being gone, but there are going to be times when you're weeping and mourning and others are rejoicing. You'll grieve, but your grief, it says your grief will turn into joy. And so now, in John chapter 16, verse 21, it says, now is your time of grief. He says, but I will see you again, and you'll rejoice, and no one can take away your joy. I hope that you'll remember that about our Lord, about our Savior, but also about Sandra. I hope that you'll remember. She was a gift that was given for a time. I pray that we will remember and be thankful for the gift of her life. And just as evidence is here today and what you said, I think that that's going to happen. I truly, truly. God bless you. I'd like to pray with you one more time. Then we'll have a kind of a song to end on. And then you'll be dismissed. Thank you so much for allowing me to be a part of this. Would you join me in prayer? Father, again, we come to you once again, just thanking you so very much for the gift of salvation and for the gift of Sandra. I pray that as this family, these friends, as they go throughout these coming days, that they will understand the peace that only you can give. Lord, that this is not goodbye, but that this is see you later for those of us who are in Christ. I pray that the Holy Spirit would stir and move in our lives, and that again we could experience the great comfort that only the great Comforter can give. Lord, I love you. Father, thank you so much for choosing me to be one who is a deliverer of your word. I pray that you found me faithful. Lord, I pray for this family especially. I pray in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I want to conclude our service. God bless you all.